Hello everyone, welcome to this session on cybersecurity. In this session, we are going to discuss about security challenges posed by mobile and wireless devices. Okay, so the two main challenges in using mobile and wireless devices are like this. So the information goes outside the perimeter, that is outside the company or organization perimeter. And the employees or users can access the organizational environment, that is the servers in the company or organization, remotely. Okay, remote access back to the protected environment. So the protected environment belongs to the company or within the organization. So these are the two main challenges. And when the mobile device users increases, that is either employees or users of the application increases, there are two kinds of devices that we, there are two kinds of challenges that we need to take care of. One is micro challenges, that is the device level challenges, and macro level challenges, that is the challenges associated or that should be considered at organizational level. Okay. Right. So this is a typical architecture or scenario which represents the access of company or organization servers through mobile or wireless devices. Okay. So you can see at the bottom communication from mobile client to organization information store. Information store is nothing but the servers that belong to the organization or company. So here are the mobile and wireless devices. Maybe they belong to the employees of the organization or they belong to the users of the application which is developed by the company or organization. So whenever they access the organizational servers through application or directly, the connection passes through, let's assume these are mobile users, they are accessing the organizational website or company website through mobile data. So the request goes through phone network. So if it is Airtel, it goes through Airtel network, or if it is BSNL, it goes through BSNL network. And then it reaches the remote access server. Okay, so from this point onwards, everything to the right, this belongs to the company or organization and their ISP. Okay, so the request reaches to the remote access server, and then this remote access server forwards the request to gateway, WAP gateway, wireless application protocol gateway. And then this gateway forwards the request to another server called application server, where the application is hosted, application or you can say website. And this application server, based on the request, will access data from either database server or it retrieves some files from file server, that is information store. Okay, so on this remote access server can communicate directly with application server after the authentication is completed. Okay, so this is how the communication from mobile client to organizational servers look like. Right, and some of the technical challenges associated with mobile devices are managing the registry settings and configurations. So this point in particular belongs to Windows Mobile, or if it is laptops which contain Windows OS. So in Windows we have something called registry. So it is like the heart of the operating system. So if the registry is corrupted, you can't access your system. Okay, and then another technical challenge is authentication service security. So before accessing any kind of application, the user needs to be authenticated. So authentication refers to identification of the user. Okay. So typically we do authentication using usernames and passwords. Otherwise, we can use biometrics like fingerprint, retinal scan, etc., etc. Right. And then another challenge is cryptography security. So this is in particular, cryptography is in particular used for aiding the confidentiality property of the system. Okay, if you need confidentiality, we can use cryptography, that is encryption and decryption. And then there is something called lightweight directory access protocol. It is in short called LDAP. So this is typically used within the organizations or companies by the employees. So it basically allows the employees to open and share files and different resources. And next one is remote access server security. So this deals with firewalls and all these things. And one more challenge is media player control security. So this deals with multimedia, okay, audio and video and associated players security. And last challenge is networking application program interface security. So that is application program interface is API. So API should also be secured against illegal access. So these are the various challenges that are also technical challenges associated with mobile devices and wireless devices. Okay, so we are going to discuss about authentication service security. So the two components of security that is associated with authentication service security are, one is security of devices, that is the device itself, that is mobiles and other devices, and second part is security in networks. So we use the devices to access the organizational servers through the network. So the network should also be secured. And now we are going to look at the types of attacks on mobile devices. So one is push attacks, another one is pull attacks, and the third one is crash attack. So this is how a push attack looks like. So here is the attacker. Let's say these are the mobile devices which belongs to the employees or users of the organization. Okay, and here is the organizational server where the application is hosted. Okay, so what the attacker will do is, attacker will try to infect these mobile devices using malware, either virus, worms, trojans, etc. Okay, once the devices are infected with let's say trojan or worm, then the attacker sends commands to these devices to attack the company or organization server. Okay, so basically what is this attack means? It's like a DDoS attack, distributed denial of service. Okay, we already discussed about how the DDoS attack works. So push attack is like a DDoS attack. And next one is pull attack. So in pull attack, so here there is attacker. So these are the devices which belongs to the attacker. So let's say there are let's consider a scenario where there is no attacker. Okay, so this device is not there and this device is not there. So this is the employee or user mobile device, and this is the access point. So access point is a router. So this is the user's router. Let's assume like that. So whenever the user or employee access the internet, let's say they are accessing the internet using the broadband, their own broadband or wireless network, So the traffic goes to the router like this. Okay, and the router sends back the required information to the mobile device. So this is the communication that will take place when there are no attacking devices. Okay, now the attacker will come into play. So he will what I mean the what the attacker will do is they will bring down the connection between the mobile device and the router. So this connection is gone. Now whenever the user or employee access the internet, instead of accessing the router, the information will go to the attacker device. Okay, and the user or employee doesn't know that. The user or employee will think that they are accessing the actual access point, that is the router, but what will happen is the data will go through the attacker's device. Okay, and then this attacking device will forward the data to the actual router, right? So this kind of attack is called man in the middle attack. Okay, so now what is this attacker doing? The attacker is accessing all the data that is being sent from the user's device to the router. So the data might include the website URLs or the application URL. It can include usernames and passwords, etc., etc. Okay, so all this data is being accessed by the attacker's device. So you can see it can see the files being sent from the mobile. It can access the email. It can access the passwords and other sensitive information. So that is pull attack. And then we have crash attack. So this can be considered as a part of push attack, which we have seen already. So you can see here, this is like a DoS attack, denial of service attack. So the attacker will already compromise different devices, or what they can do is the attacker can infect many devices like this. So you can think of these attacking devices like bots or zombies in a DoS attack, and all the malicious devices will be sending different kinds of junk data to the user device. So the user device will crash. That is why the attack name is known as crash attack. So the device itself or the service running on the device will shut down or restart. Okay, so this attack affects the availability. Okay, so wherever you see DoS or DDoS attack, they always affect the availability of the system or service. So that is about the three types of attacks: push, pull, and crash. So now we are going to see some other attacks which can be performed on mobile devices through wireless networks. Okay, so first one is DoS attacks. I already explained this denial of service attack, so I am not going to explain. And next one is traffic analysis. So this is how traffic analysis looks like. So this is the employee or user's mobile device. This is the router that belongs to the user or employee. And using this router, the employee will access internet. Okay, and this router belongs to the ISP, or you can say it belongs to the company or organization. And finally you access the internet. Okay, so this is the actual path of communication. Now the attacker will tap into this communication and see whatever your data you are sending in their machine. Okay, in their desktop or laptop. So whatever URLs you are seeing, whatever username and passwords you are sending, every type of data is captured by this attacker. So this is called as sniffing. Okay, sniffing means they are only monitoring the communication. Okay, they are not trying to stop the communication or send something different to you. They are just monitoring what you are seeing and what kind of information you are sending. That is called sniff. So from this, they sniff the data on the network. They do some analysis and they extract some interesting features. And finally, they identify what kind of web pages you are seeing and what are the usernames and passwords, what is the email you are sending, etc., etc. So that is called traffic analysis. And then there is eavesdropping. So this is kind of a physical attack where in case of wide networks, this is a physical attack, like when there is Ethernet connection. So someone with the malicious intent, that is an attacker, will tap into the communication line physically using some devices, and they will monitor the data being sent by all the users across the Ethernet. And in wireless networks, it is somewhat similar to traffic analysis. Okay. And then we have man-in-the-middle attacks. This we have just seen in the pull attack. Okay. So someone comes into the in the middle, and they will hijack all the traffic that you are sending to the router. So that is called man-in-the-middle attack. So it is somewhat different from traffic analysis. In traffic analysis, the attacker only monitors the data, whereas man in the middle attacks, they can send fabricated data to the user, or malicious data back to the user. They will interrupt the communication. They can interrupt the communication. But in traffic analysis, the attacker will never interrupt the communication. They will only just sniff. Okay, so this is the man in the middle. So this is the original communication path. Okay, so after man in the middle attack, the data goes through the attacker. Okay, right. And then last one is session hijacking. So it is somewhat like this. So here is the user's device, and here is the company or organization device. And here is the attacking device. So there is a concept called session. Okay, session means it is a combination of requests that you send from one point in time to another point in time. For example, when you log into the Facebook website, that is the starting of a session. So after logging into the Facebook, you will do some activities, and finally you will log out of the Facebook. So that logout can be considered as the end of session. So in between you will do several things. So all those activities or events belongs to the session. Okay, and whenever you log in, a session ID will be sent back to the user's browser. Okay, so just like this, 1, 2, 3, 4. Actually, in reality, session IDs are not like this. They are lengthy strings which are encrypted. So whenever you are sending the session ID, the browser is sending the session ID to the server. So the attacker can access that session ID, and they can use this session ID to replicate the user. Okay, right? Okay, that is, this technique is called session hijacking, or you can say it is called cookie hijacking. Right. And how can you protect yourself from all these kinds of attacks is by using wireless application protocols, the standard protocols. You can use another thing called VPNs, virtual private networks, which creates a tunnel between the client device and the target server. And then you can use MAC filtering, media access control filtering. So this is available at the router, or you can say the access point, where you can give a list of MAC addresses which can access the router. All other devices will not be able to access the router. Okay, MAC filtering. Or we can use the standards. Okay, 802.xx. So xx refers to different numbers. For example, 802.11 belongs to Wi-Fi. Okay, we can use these standards to protect ourselves. So that's it about authentication service security. Thank you.